Also, we need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He save us from hellfire. And this is something very major. Many times we don't understand. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to teach Sahaba a dua. And he used to teach them as he used to teach them Quran. The dua he used to teach them, there is a two dua that Prophet used to teach them as he used to teach like Quran. First dua is istikhara, and this is the second dua. He used to teach them that you say in your prayer before you make salam. Every tashahud. And subhanallah, Prophet used to give importance to this dua that much, like a surah of Quran, and we don't know the dua. The dua is, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min azab jahannam. Wa a'udhu bika min azab al-qabr. وأعوذ بك من فتنة المسيح الدجال وأعوذ بك من فتنة المحيا والممات. Very small dua. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to teach Sahaba to say this dua in your tashahud before you make salam. And he used to order them to do it. Now, it means, O Allah, I seek refuge in you from the punishment of hellfire. The second, O Allah, I seek refuge from you from the punishment of the grave. O Allah, I seek refuge in you from the trial of Dajjal, Antichrist. O Allah, I seek refuge in you from the trial of life and the death. We are always in the trial. Every day there is an exam. Every day there is a trial and fitna in the front of you. Allah said that innama amwalukum wa auladukum what? Fitna. Dollar in your pocket and your children are fitna. They are a trial. How is the fitna? Because each time when the matter of the dollar comes, some people, their iman start shaking. Halal and haram is not important. It needs to come anyway. If the money is coming, let it come. So, also children. Many times people do wrong thing because of the children. Many times people fight one another because of the children. Many times people get busy because of the children. Many times people, they do all those wrong because their family, their children, because the family and the children. And you make a study. We sometimes ruined our akhirah and jannah because of our children. And let me read a few ayat in Quran. يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَ إِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ. Allah said, in the day of resurrection, people will run away and hide from one another. Person will hide from his brother, his father, his mother, his wife, his children, his relatives. Everybody will run away. Why? Because maybe my brother asked me a hasana. Maybe he, you know, complained against me. Maybe my brother asked me favor today. That day will be so big. Allah said, فَلَا أَنْصَابَ بَيْنَهُمَا وَلَا هُمْ يَتَسَأَلُونَ. There will be nobody ask other person, you are who and belong to which family? What is the name of your father? Nobody will care. Dear brothers, you know the day of judgment is something we underestimate, something we forgot about it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran that inna zalzalat as-sa'ati shay'un 'azim. You know, he says the zalzala, and you know, like earthquake or shake of the qiyamah will be so great and big. يوم تضع كل مرضعة كل ذات حمل حملها. You know, وترى الناس سكارى. Allah says, وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. People, they become crazy. They were run around and they seem like crazy people running. They are not crazy. But because the worry, because the fear, because the hellfire will, you know, as the, you know what the thunderstorm is? And you hear the thunderstorms and you see the clouds coming. Hellfire will scream at that day and people will hear the scream of the hellfire and their hearts start, you know, shaking. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned one hadith. Ummul Mumineen radiyallahu ta'ala anha asked him, O Prophet of Allah, people will be naked in the day of judgment, men and women will be naked. Prophet says, yes, Aisha, they will be. Wal amru adam. But the akhirah will be so big that nobody even think. Nobody even has the thought for a second. They will be in the front of Allah. Everybody worry about their akhirah. We need to ask Allah's forgiveness. We need to seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of hellfire and the grave. When we do this dua, and you have a little time, so you ask Allah to give you what you are looking for. Or you can specifically mention the name of the things which you want, or you can ask Allah and say, Allah, whatever good for me, give it to me. And let me tell you something. This is the last thing. I want to share with you two things quickly. And imagine the deep, try to look at the deep. You know Imam Abul Atahiyya. Imam Abul Atahiyya. Whenever he needs something, he used to ask Allah and say, Oh Allah, please Allah, be happy with me. Oh Allah, forgive me and be happy with me. People used to ask him, Imam, why don't you ask Allah to give you such and such? He said, I did. Well, you didn't. Yes, I did. How you did? Because when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, be happy with me. And he said, when Allah is happy with me, he will take care of my every needs. He know what I need. All I need is fix my relationship with him. When I become his friend, when he become my friend, he know what I need. He know me more than I know myself. Right?